Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. This is part 3 of our Thousand Trails Elite Connection series. In this episode, we'll be talking about the things we don't like about the Elite Connections. In case you haven't watched our previous videos, we recently upgraded our old membership to the new Thousand Trails Elite Connections membership. The Elite Connections membership package offers a whole lot, and I do suggest that you watch our previous videos to learn more. In this video, I'll be using the awesome drone footage I got out at Birch Bay Thousand Trails for the backdrop of this discussion. Before I go much further, I'd like to just let you know that I really do like the Elite Connections membership package. It is working well for us at this point. There are also a couple other key points such as cabin rentals and cruises that I didn't touch on. I'll have in an upcoming video. I'll also be covering the fact that the Elite Connections package is a willable campground package that you can pass on to your children in the future. Even though this membership package has a lot going for it, there's still room for improvement, and that's what we'll discuss in today's video. One of the first things that comes to mind for both Christy and I is the misconception that you can actually stay in the parks all the time. 21 days, you're in one park, and then you can move on to the next park without any problems. However, there is a sneaky problem, and that is the holidays. Keeping in mind that holidays are the most booked times for Thousand Trails, they allow you to book only one major holiday at any given time. And also keeping in mind that Thousand Trails does consider holidays such as Canada Day, US holidays, that can really throw you off. You also have to understand that Canada Day and 4th of July come basically back to back. Of course, this is only one example that really deals with the Northwest Territory. However, you do have to consider all holidays and major times of the year depending on where you're going to stay. Another thing you're not going to really hear about in the brochure is that the campgrounds kind of discriminate on their own basis to how many campers they have in the campground at one time. So really it can change from day to day or week to week depending on how full they are. So always make sure you can book as early as you can or you're going to be affected by these rules. Another thing that can really affect the way that you book is by trying to book online. We have found out that calling directly to the Thousand Trails booking agent and speaking with a representative is going to be your best way. Remember, many of the members already understand how this works, so you're generally going to have to wait about 10 to 15 minutes to get through on the call. Remember, the Thousand Trails will generally let you use a phone at the ranger station to make a call, and that's a good thing because most of the time you're not going to have cell phone, at least most of the time. While we're on the subject, cell phone is a real disadvantage. Wi-Fi is a real disadvantage at Thousand Trails parks for the most part. There are a few parks that actually offer to sell you Wi-Fi service, and to me that's a poke in the arm, especially at the level of membership that we are currently at. These are the issues we have, but for the most part, we love our membership.